Hey guys, what's going on? We're back with you, and today we are covering a muscle we haven't never covered before here, and that's the calf muscle. It's something that's overlooked by a lot of people. I'm guilty of it. I overlook it a lot. I don't train it very much.
Sometimes easy to cover.
I'll be honest. It's easy to cover. Well, we're going to cover it today. We're going to cover it today, and we're going to talk about how you can train it and what it is. Now, the calf muscle is a group of two different muscles, the soleus and the gastrocnemius. Okay, so you want to do exercises that's going to work those muscles. Now, both of those muscles do the function of what's called plantar flexion. It's pointing your toe down toward the ground. Okay, both muscles do that. The gastrocnemius also flexes the knee a little bit because it crosses the knee joint.
That has two heads, right?
It has two heads. It has a medial and a lateral head. Right, exactly. The soleus sits a little bit deeper than the gastroc, so if you build that soleus up, a little bit of itch.
Mask.
If you build the soleus up, it's going to push that gastrocnemius more up, kind of like similar to when we talked about the bicep, remember?
Yeah.
The long head of the bicep, if we build up the brachialis, that brachialis is going to push that long head of the bicep up. It's kind of the same principle here.
Well, it's more of like a pull, like a pulling muscle than a pushing muscle.
Yeah, so. But the point is it lays below another muscle, so it can build it up, it's going to push the muscle above it.
Yeah.
Up, if that makes sense.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so let's get right to it here. We did two different exercises. We did both the seated calf raise.
Yes.
And then we did a standing calf raise. And of course, when you're doing a seated calf raise, I think everybody's familiar with that. I mean, Every single gym that I know,
it's always there. You get the most, in my opinion, you get like the most feeling out of that one, or the most flex, maybe the most pinching type of flex where you get the peak contraction versus that standing. Kind of depends on where you're getting it though.
So. Right, exactly. And we're also going to talk about how much weight you should use and then how quickly you should go, if you should bounce. You see a lot of bouncing going on the movements.
Explosive Achilles snapping.
Yeah, and that's what people are doing. They're using the Achilles tendon and the elasticity of that of that tendon to just kind of snap the movement up and down, not really focusing a lot of attention on the muscle itself, but rather the Achilles tendon. And
you could probably affect that tendon with an isometric hold on that too. You wouldn't even have to worry about that.
Yeah.
So then you wouldn't be really affecting just that. You would be working your muscle as
well. The muscle, yeah. So that's another way you could do it too. But we're going to make a conscious effort to pause at the bottom of each rep. So as I was doing on the seated calf raise machine, I'm pausing. I'm getting a good solid stretch, eliminating any of that elastic reflex that the Achilles might create, and just focusing the tension on the muscle where we want it to be, of course. And then you did the standing.
Yes.
And here you're focusing a little bit more on the gastroc. You're keeping the legs straight pretty much for the most part.
Yeah.
But you were going down and up. And then
I haven't done those for a while either.
Then you'll probably feel it just after one set tomorrow.
I usually just go to seated, but you know, I couldn't even do those for a while. Like before we tried and I put that pad on my knee.
Yeah.
It's just
not quite there.
It was like a staple. And then now you have to like actually set up the standing.
So. Yeah. Well, you know, but it works differently. Your seated is going to hit a little bit more soleus. You're going to hit more gastroc on the standing.
You can get more rounding.
And then you did, what about your toes?
Toes, as far as like
toe positioning.
Yeah, well, the first one I did was the toe out, but the heel in. Mm-hmm. This was really be affecting more of the inner calf, the inner gastroc on the back of your leg. Basically, when you turn like so, you can see that the inner flexes more, especially in that video that we made.
Yeah.
And then when you turn them out, just like I did the second time where I readjusted my feet in that video. You work more of the outer, which is kind of more of the soleus or the outer gastroc, where you see a lot of that outer flexing in the outer part of the calf muscle. When you see people with a lot of lines, you can tell which ones they've done more of or how they walk.
Yeah.
Or when you see people with the inner part of like the calves like that.
Yeah.
Mine kind of developed a little more round because I started, I used to walk straight.
Uh-huh.
And I started skating. So feet kind of got more toes out.
Okay.
Plus my dad's military, said, walk with your toes out, boy.
So that was ingrained into you at an early age to walk with your toes out.
So basically got a little bit more of a, kind of an overall, because my calves kind of round past that knee. So I think that's where I got it.
Okay.
But I kind of do variations as well.
Yeah. So something's going to feel more natural. I mean, I know there's been some studies even that have shown that there's not a whole lot of difference if you put your toes out and toes in.
Yeah.
But I don't know. There is.
And
that's
you're pressing through a different part of your foot. Yeah. I mean, just imagine, and you can see that in a lot of running backs too, especially the side of their leg, because they're always, you know, going from side to side. So when you come out here, you get a lot of flexion through the outer part of your foot.
Right.
You're not flexing in the inner part of your foot, so that part of your calf muscle is really not flexing as much as this part.
Right.
So it really does work. So
yeah. Okay. So You kind of find out what works for you and what you need to develop. If you're lacking one area, then make a conscious effort to develop the other area. Obviously, you want to try to balance things out. So that's interesting. I think calves is something we haven't covered. It's something that we should cover. It's an area that isn't usually even judged in bodybuilding.
Yeah, well, they used to. It used to be judged on proportion. Like, they wanted your calves to be the same size as your biceps.
Years ago. Way back.
Yeah. They actually were, too. Yeah. But really, the only way that they would do that is high rep into progressive overload. Mm-hmm. And that's kind of how I would train my legs. Is like, you get high reps, you get a lot of blood pumping, you get a nice pump in, and then you overload. So you overload that muscle, and it gets it to pop out, expand, and then it adjusts over time with that overload, and your muscle gets bigger.
Right.
And if you're eating,
eating, of course, has a lot to do with it. You also want to make sure that you train it often, because the calves are not easily impressed. I mean, think about it. All day long, you're walking around on your calf muscles. They're not going to be super impressed. So you have to hit them frequently, and you got to hit them with some heavier loads.
What about the guys that walk like this? What about the guys that walk like this?
Yeah,
that makes you. Seen them in public?
Yeah, I have.
I bet their calves are definitely impressed by the end of the day.
Yeah, probably. But over time, even they are their calves are going to get used to it. So you got to shock the muscle, just like any other body part. You got to shock the muscle.
Like this big by the end of the day.
You got to make sure that you have to maybe kick the calves in the seat, so to speak, a little bit more. Does that make sense? Yeah. Anyway, So guys, give this a try. I know you guys have probably done the seated calf raise machine before, but make sure you incorporate some standing variations so you hit both the soleus and the gastroc. So I think we've covered. We did the hamstrings, we did the quads, and then we hit the calves today. So we have covered a lot of legs over the past month or so.
We can maybe focus on like abductors, adductors, and why we shouldn't use the piriformis to pull. And you should be using other parts of your body to pull. When other parts get tired, you use something else. It comes up as a secondary, it's like a secondary primary mover. So we could do something like that.
Yeah. Or if you guys want to see something, make sure you send your questions our direction. We'll try to do our best to address that.
Add videos.
In future videos.
Tricep videos.
Anything fitness related, we'll be glad to help you guys out with.
Back videos.
Exactly. So you guys have a good week. We will see you before long.
See you guys.